Yes, stepping a little bit more inside the topic, inside the chapter. Now, what which topic we are going to discuss right now? It is types of matrices. Okay, we are having types of matrices. Types of matrices. Now, number one, column matrix. Now, what column matrix is? A matrix having only one column, that is a matrix. So, for example, we are having, I am just writing the order 1 cross 1, 1 by 1, 2 by 1, 3 by 1, 4 by 1. We are having so many orders, but only one column should be there. Okay. Now we are having A is equal to 1. This is called only one. Okay. 1 cross 1 it can be. Order can be 1 cross 1. Then B. B is with 4 and 5. We are having order 2 by 1. Okay. Two elements. Means two rows and one column. Column is one. C. Suppose we are having now 0, 1 and 2. Again one column. So these are called column matrices. Okay. So after column matrices, next will be we are having now row matrix. Okay. Second is row matrix. Now in the row matrix, what we are having? Only one row. Now, just I am writing the order first. Order. Suppose we are having 1 cross 1, 1 cross 2, 1 cross 3, 1 cross 4. Or it is called 1 by 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4. Okay. Now only single row we are having. Again, A is equal to 1. This represents also one row and one column, one and the same thing. So order is 1 cross 1, B, 1, 2. And remember, we are not putting commas here. We are not putting commas in between the elements. And you can represent like this also. You can represent like this also. Okay, a big bracket. Then C. Now what is the order here? 1 by 2, one row, two columns. C. What this represents? One row, three columns. So this is column row matrix. Now we have gone with two types, column matrix and row matrix. Okay. So let's move for the third part. And the third part is now, third is an interesting part. It is what we can say square matrix. Now, when we are using the word square matrix, what it represents? Just look, if I am writing the order in the form of M cross M. Now, M cross M means number of rows and number of columns, they are same. Okay, M cross M or M cross N, where we can write M is equal to N. It represents a square matrix. Okay. Now, square matrix, we can write it A is equal to 1. Suppose now here I am just changing. Suppose it is 6. Order is 1 cross 1. A is equal to, let it be B. B is equal to now 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, this represents what? 2 cross 2. Number of rows, number of columns are equal. C, we are having A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. Okay, and this is the capital C. So, now this represents what? Three rows and three columns. So, this is a square matrix. It is called a square matrix. Now, in the square matrix, what we are having? number of rows and number of columns should be same. Okay, or it can be a order can be m cross m, order can be n cross n, one and the same thing. So these are called square matrices. Okay, so after square matrix, now we are having diagonal matrix. Diagonal matrix. Now in the diagonal matrix, again diagonal matrix means a type of a square matrix. Okay, so we are having, now suppose we are having A is equal to 4 5 6. I am just making 3 by 3 square matrix for 3 by 3, and rest are 0. This is called a diagonal matrix. Okay, second thing for this diagonal, for this diagonal matrix, this is what, this is diagonal matrix. And in the diagonal matrix, what these are called, what this is called, this is called principal diagonal. It is called principal diagonal. Okay, and these elements are called diagonal elements. These are called diagonal elements. Okay, and principal diagonal elements can be any, and they can be integers, plus, minus, anything. They can be real, they can be complex, they can be imaginary. Okay, but remaining elements should be zero. This is called a diagonal matrix. Okay, again, diagonal matrix, principal diagonal and diagonal elements. Okay, so after diagonal matrices, now, and remember, diagonal matrix is in the formation of a square matrix. Let it be, after diagonal matrix we are going with a unit with, let it be a scalar matrix first. Scalar matrix. Now how we are representing a scalar matrix? Scalar matrix A is equal to, now we are having 4 4 0 0. Now this is for 2 by 2. Okay, now the principal diagonal should be having same value, same face value should be there, same digit should be there for the principal value. It is 4 4, it can be 3 3, by 2 2, any. So that is called a scalar multi, scalar matrices. Okay, you can write it like this also, 2 0 0 0 2 0 0 0 2. So this is what, again a scalar matrix with order 3 by 3, 3 rows, 3 columns. Okay, so when the elements are equal, then it is called a scalar matrix of elements of the principal diagonal only, rest are 0. And if the elements are not equal, for the diagonal elements are not equal and rest are 0, then it is called diagonal matrix. Okay, so very nearby results for the diagonal matrix and a scalar matrix. Okay, so after this, now we are having a very very important type of a matrix. I will tell you how we are going to use this, where we are going to use this. Okay, so this is unit or identity, unit or identity matrix, a very important matrix, very important. Okay, now identity. Now what are the conditions for this, for the identity matrix? Number one, is a square matrix. It is a square matrix. Number two, related with scalar matrix. Okay, related with the scalar matrix, square matrix related with the scalar matrix. Okay, number three, representation, represented by I. Okay, Now I represents what? Identity matrix or a unit matrix. Now what you remember what unit means? We are taking unit circle. Unit circle means what? A circle having radius 1. Similarly, a unit matrix. Unit matrix means a matrix with 1. What 1? What 1 a matrix? It should be order. It should be a square form and it is represented by order. I am going to tell you, and always it is 1 1 matrix, it is 2 2, it is 3 3, it is 4 4. Always it represents 1 in the matrix. Okay. So it can be written as, if we are writing I1, if we are writing I1, we can write I2, we can write I3. Numbers on the base. Or we can move with like this. So all these represents unit matrix, identity matrix. Now how we are formation is, for the unit matrix we are having this is also 1 into 1, 1 cross 1, 1 0 0 1, 2 cross 2, this is also identity matrix. For square matrix, for order 3, 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1, 3 cross 3. So all these are identity matrix, a very very important part. Okay. This is also identity matrix representing 1. This is also representing 1. This is also identity matrix. This is also identity matrix. This is for order 2 times 2 by 2, and this is for 3 by 3. Okay. Principal diagonal. Elements of principal diagonal are 1. This is what? A scalar matrix. Okay. So identity matrix, unit or the identity matrix, it is represented where orders are same. Orders are, you can say it, A, I, J, and the orders are N cross N. Okay, it can be M cross M, it can be N cross N. Okay, so it represents a identity matrix. Now, what other possibilities there? Now, just check it. Now, I can just represent, we can show you that what exactly it is. Now, we are having identity matrix A represents A is equal to 1 if I is equal to J, 0 if I is not equal to J. This is also possibility there. How? Now let's check it for this part. Now this is what? A11. For 2 into 2, let's use only this part. I am using now for explaining for this part. Okay, for this part, what is A11? That is 1. What is A12? That is 0. What is A21? It is 0. What is A22? It is 1. Now, I is equal to J. I is not equal to J. Okay? Here, 1 is not equal to 2. I is not equal to J. So, it is 0. I is not equal to J. Here 2 is not equal to 1. No, it is not possible. Here I is equal to J. Similarly, you can check here also. This is A11, A22, A33, where I and J are equal. So if I and J are equal, always write 1. If and I and J are not equal, always write 0. The formation becomes identity matrix. Okay, a unit matrix. Now, especially for this identity part, let me give you a question. Okay, if suppose it was given, if A is equal to cos alpha minus sine alpha cos alpha. Now, this is given to you. A matrix capital A represents this, and the order is 2 by 2. Okay. Now, then what is the value for alpha? Okay, alpha is what? It is an angle. Then what is the value of alpha so that A gets identity matrix? What is the alpha, what is the value of alpha so that A gets identity matrix? Now what they want? They want, if A is equal to cos alpha minus sin alpha, and cos alpha. So they want to this to be 1001. Is it possible? So what should be the value of alpha so that we can get this as a 1 0 0 and 1? Now you have done a trigonometry in class 11. What is cos 0? We are having cos 0 is equal to 1 and sin 0 is equal to 0. So if alpha is 0, then we can get, when if alpha is 0, we can write matrix A is an identity matrix. Okay, so this is an identity matrix, a nice example for identity matrix. Okay, so you can write it, if alpha is 0, then A becomes identity matrix. Okay, so now next, after this one, now we can go for next type of a matrix, that is triangular matrix. Now we can move for a triangular matrix. Now in the triangular matrix, what we are having, A is equal to suppose we are having 1, 4, 6, 7, 8, 0, 0, 0. Okay. Then B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay. So triangular matrix means only principal values. We should have some principal diagonal. Principal diagonal should have some values, and above the diagonal we should also have some values other than zeros. Okay, so this is called upper triangular matrix, and this is called lower triangular matrix. Okay, upper triangular matrix and lower triangular matrix, where in the upper triangular region, elements other than the principal diagonals on the upper side should be some elements rather than zero, and in the lower part, upper should be zero, lower should be having some values, and which they are representing in the formation of triangle. Let's check it. Now this represents a triangle. Okay, so now after this we are having last, a very simple type, that is comparable matrices. We can write it comparable matrix. Now in the comparable matrix, what it is, if two matrices have same order, then it is comparable matrices. Okay, A is equal to 1, 2, 3, and B is equal to A, B, C. Now what is the order? Row matrix 1 cross 3, 1 by 3, B. So this is a comparable matrix, means order is same, the matrix, we can say these are the comparable matrix. Now after doing this very 6 or 8 types of, we have done matrices. Now we are going for an next topic. Okay.